Hello, this is Hirudov's YouTube channel, and now I will unbox and test for you a Samsung SSD 960GB M.2 PM953 PCI Express NVMe and so on, 110mm. This is a second-hand product which I bought from eBay for very good price, $90.99, almost $91, for 960GB Samsung SSD. So the price was irresistible. I checked and it's much more expensive now, over $100, so it's a good price. I can feel it inside. I waited during a lockdown for a long time, so now let's open and see if second-hand SSD is good for what is it being sold. Hopefully it's the correct amount of storage inside. Pretty well packaged with glue, so somebody won't swap it during the shipment. And inside the package is another package. This one is empty. So many packaging packages. Bubble wrapped. And placed in anti-static bag at the end. You see nothing in the other four packages it was placed in. And here it is. 960GB inside this 960GB NVMe second hand. Hopefully there won't be any issues with it. Front side, back side. Pretty lightweight. Now let's go test it. Now let's see where I shall insert the SSD M.2 drive on this MCI motherboard. This is from the glass preview. Aha, I see it under the Corsair cooling. You see the slot and the screw under the HyperX memory modules, above the MCI GeForce RTX graphics board and the Blackmagic Design Decklink 4K. Easy to find now when I have overview of the motherboard. First thing is to turn off the computer. Now computer is turned off and laid on the floor. I have my screwdriver set ready. The SSD. And first remove the glass side cover to reveal the motherboard. Have to be careful with this glass. Now insert the SSD. It's tilted at 45 degrees now, or 30. When I push it, it holds down, but it's not fixed. I need to fix it now. After the SSD is fixed, I push it to test if it will move. Not very strong. It doesn't move. That means it won't fall when I place the tower upright. It's stable. Now putting everything back together. First the glass cover. It fits and I can see the my two NV SSD. After the tens of cables are connected, I am ready to test the SSD. First, turn on the computer. It boots. In Board Explorer, I see my device M.21 connector PCI Express device remapping. And here I have the old one. Now I have two flash drives SSD. After getting M2 Jenny error, here is what's needed to be done. Settings, advanced, Windows OS configuration. And here I have to switch to UEFI, UEFI for Windows 10 WHQL support, or else it won't boot. Now I was able to boot into Windows. First thing is to run Crystal Disk Info. And here it is. Samsung MZ1LV960. Everything cleared, including total host reads and writes, power on count second time. Now I'm starting it. I needed to fix some M2 Jenny errors. And next thing is disk management. Create and format hard disk partitions. Okay, it says you must initialize a disk before Logical Disk Manager can access it. I will do the GPT partition table and here new simple volume. Maximum disk size in megabytes 915,698. I will assign a letter F. File system NT file system. And it's done. I have a new volume.
894 gigabytes. Let's do a speed test. To test the speed and working capabilities of this second-hand SSD, I have copied the contents of my projects to the RAM drive, which is the fastest possible. There is no slowdown because of the disk interfaces. Here I have some files. One of them is 2 gigabytes big, other is another one, and smaller files. These are video files, which will be copied now to the SSD. Let's do copy. New volume, new SSD, paste. Wow. What was this speed? Let's try again. A speed of over 1 gigabyte. Let's try with other folder. Here I have 150 megabytes of projects, but it's 2,362 files. Let's copy this as well. Paste. Wow! It's amazingly fast. Let's try bot. Now, copy, new volume, paste. Wow, very nice new SSD, second hand, running now Crystal Disk Info. Temperature is 55 degrees. Total host reads 0 gigabytes. Total host writes 21 gigabytes. 2 times power tone. 61 degrees temperature. More than normal. But it works. Compared to my other SSD, which is NVMe Express 1.3, it's slightly slower, but it's nice and it's higher capacity. This is Samsung SSD 970 Pro, 512 gigabytes, while this one is 960 gigabytes. Let's see properties. This one is 476 gigabytes, while the new volume is 875 gigabytes. Thanks for watching my video. See you in my next videos.